Oshomole begs Otom for out-of-court settlement in 10 billion naira libel suit. Hello everyone, welcome back to our channel. So good to have you guys back here again. Thank you once again for your support. We really appreciate you. Yes, my people, Oshomole is begging the governor of Benue State right now. We remember back in 2018, the then national chairman, obviously he's suspended now, the then national chairman of the All Progressive Congress laid an accusation. It looks like APC, they are good at making allegations and accusations. Remember the accusation they laid against Mike Igini, INEC's wreck, and he did not hesitate to slam them with a fine as well. So this one has been in the courts, but right now Oshomole is begging for out-of-court settlement, most probably because maybe the way Edo State election went, he doesn't have any connection, any link anymore. He's still suspended as the national chairman. Things are not really going his way right now, so he's begging for court out-of-court settlement with the governor of Benue State. We'll get more details shortly, guys, but before we do, please, if you haven't given us a thumbs up, do give this video a thumbs up. Click on the like button. Don't forget to share and to subscribe as well. Thank you once again. Yes, we'll go straight into the news now and grab all of the details. The former chairman of the All Progressive Congress, APC, Comrade Adams Oshomole, on Tuesday sought for out-of-court settlement in the 10 billion naira libel suit that was filed against him by Benue State Governor Samuel Otom. Governor Otom had filed a libel suit against the former APC chairman over his comments against him in the APC-sponsored press conference held on July 27, 2018, wherein Oshomole accused him of having a hand in the death of two Catholic priests and other parishioners at Mamblo Community, Gwa East Local Government, on the grounds that one of the priests had preached a very critical sermon against the governor before that attack. Oshomole, in the early days of the suit, had filed six preliminary objections, all of which were resolved in favor of Governor Otom by the court. When the case resumed on Tuesday for definite hearing, counsel to Governor Otom, Samuel Irabo, told the court that he was ready to call his witness, but that Oshomole's counsel had informed him earlier that they have considered putting up a retraction of the publication and that it will be ready within a week. Otom's counsel explained further that it was based on that he was applying for another date to take a look at the terms of settlement as canvassed by Oshomole. On his part, Titus Akwa, who held the brief of Oshomole's counsel, Festus Jumbo, confirmed the submission of Governor's Otom's lawyer. That is the true position of the matter. We have met and we are drawing out terms of settlement. The presiding judge, Justice Augustine Itwonyima, after listening to both parties, adjourned the case to October 29th for report on the out-of-court settlement. It will be recalled that Governor Otom, in the suit, among other things, averred that Oshomole allegedly assassinated his character and damaged his reputation when an APC-sponsored press conference held on Friday, July 27, 2018, he accused him of having a hand in the death of two Catholic priests and other parishioners at Mamblo Community on the ground that one of the priests had preached a very critical sermon against him. Some of the relief sought by Governor Otom include a 10 billion naira suit against Oshomole, include a declaration by the court that the defendant's allegation and publication of July 27th against him are false, mischievous, unsubstantiated, defamatory, and libelous, an order directing the defender to publish simultaneous retractions and apologies in respect of the said libelous publication against him in the Sunday editions of 10 national dailies circulating within Benue State, as well as paid advertorials to the same effect on the prime time beats of the Nigerian Television Authority, Channels TV, TVC News, African Independent Television, AIT, Independent Television, ITV, Benin Radio Nigeria, Radio Benue, and Harvest FM. An order of perpetual injunction restraining the defendant, their officers, privies, assigns, surrogates, or agents, whoever called for further defamation and labeling the plaintiff's character and reputation and any other orders that the court may deem fit to make in the circumstance. Wow. Oshomole, Oshomole. Like I said, I don't know if this APC are good at making all of this allegation. Right now, they are dealing with the Mikey Guinea, and right now, they are even changing the story. They are changing the whole narrative that and denying everything when they saw the amount of the suit. Anyway, that one is still in court. So right now, Oshomole has looked at it that he's not going to win out of this. And like I said, most probably, with the way things have gone lately, he's no longer the national chairman. So those his connections. And you know, someone stated that the one thing that has affected Oshomole majorly is the death of the chief of staff, the former chief of staff, Abba Kyari. Because it was said that both of them were close allies. They've known way back. And anytime Oshomole gets into any kind of trouble, he runs to Abba Kyari for help. And Abba Kyari tends to bail him out. Remember the earlier one during the start of the year when he was suspended by the court. Abba Kyari bailed him out. But right now, when when the court, Federal High Court, upheld the suspension by his ward, there was no Abba Kyari. That is the suspension he's still on up till date. And he has looked at it that the way things are going, I need to just settle all my issues right now. So he's called out to Governor Autumn to settle out of court. So he's not even denying that he did not make such statements or allegations against the governor of Benue State. And the governor of Benue State is saying that that comment has tarnished his image, and as a result of that, Oshomole has to pay for it. Let's see. In the case, because Oshomole advanced with out-of-court settlement, the court had no choice but to wait for the both parties to see how their settlement goes, and they adjourned the case. Oshomole would see if the governor of Benue State will actually accept all of this that Oshomole is putting forward, the out-of-court settlement. I'm sure this might be taking Oshomole by a surprise, because we know this case has been ongoing since 2018. Most probably he's thinking that by now he would have been so influential, maybe so powerful, and find a way to bail himself out of this. But things didn't go as he planned. He's still suspended. And then he still has to deal with this. He still has to face Governor Autumn, the governor of Benue State. Guys, let's hear your own take about Oshomole's, what is going on with Oshomole. Thank you once again. Please don't forget to give this video a thumbs up, subscribe, and also share. Till I come your way again, bye for now, and God bless.